Today we've got a new fairy tale themed nail art look for you. This was actually a request from Sassy Family here on YouTube. Because I actually hadn't thought of this fairy tale yet. However, it is a very cool fairy tale, I think. So, yeah. Let's get started. As a background color, I'm using Fotheringay Castle by A. England, which, as you can see, is a lovely shade of forest green. It's really, really stunning, and in the right sort of lighting, which obviously isn't this sort of lighting, but in the right sort of lighting, it actually has some holographic glitter in it as well. I felt like doing pretty much an unnecessarily complicated background this time. So while the nail polish was still wet, I've also put some gold glitter on the tips and just slightly spread it out with a fan brush and just made sure to really press it in there. And then I also added some feather stickers. If you want to do something more simple, you could just do this and not add all the painting. Alternatively, if you are, planning on painting your nails as well, be a little bit smarter about it than I was and actually think of where you're going to paint before putting on the stickers, because on the middle nail I completely ended up covering the stickers with the paint, so yeah, that was sort of a waste of stickers. But yeah, nevertheless, I do actually like how much detail it puts in the background. And then for painting, as always, I'm just using acrylic paint and a detail brush, just an eBay nail art brush, which I've actually cut a little bit thinner, well, a lot thinner myself, to make sure it's thin enough for the sort of paint I want to do. And yeah, about the fairy tale, there's actually a lot of versions. I'm going by the one with the 6 brothers. There's also a version of 12 brothers who get turned into swans. I think the original legend I read it somewhere was also, I think, 12, but I'm not sure, actually. It also ended differently, but yeah, point is, the fairy tale, the one with the 6 swans, it started out with a king being lost in a forest, and then he encountered a witch, because, it's a fairy tale, so when you get lost in the forest, you can pretty much count on either encountering a witch or something else that's going to eat you. But yeah, this witch actually had different plans. She told him that she was very willing to tell him how to get out of the forest if he would agree to marry her daughter, because her daughter, according to her, was beautiful and really deserved to be a queen. Yep. Okay. Obviously, she thought her daughter was beautiful because she was her mother, so obviously the king wasn't very into that idea. However, he was very terrified of, starving alone in the forest. So he agreed to it, and as it turned out, the witch's daughter was indeed beautiful, but she was also terrifying because she was also a mean witch. So yeah, not very surprisingly, he didn't actually trust her with his children because he had been married before. So I'm just going to assume his wife died. They didn't actually mention it in the story, but anyway. But yeah, he actually put his children in a different castle. His 6 sons and 1 daughter, he put them in a different castle, far away, deep in the forest, completely hidden. And the only reason he could find it was because a wise woman, an old and wise woman, gave him a ball of yarn which rolled out to show him where the castle was. So yeah, he hid away his children there. However, his wife did, of course, notice after a while that he was sort of, randomly missing very often. So yeah, in modern days, one would just assume that he was cheating on her. But yeah, she actually decided to figure out what exactly he was actually doing. And so she found out about the ball of yarn, and she also found out he had 6 sons. She didn't find out about the daughter, which, is good, because otherwise we wouldn't have much of a fairy tale. So what she did, because she was also obviously a witch, she actually sewed 6 shirts and then stole the ball of yarn while the king was away and went to the castle. And because no one else actually ever visited, of course, because no one could find the castle in the first place, the children immediately thought it was their father coming towards them. So they obviously ran to him to greet him, but it turned out to be the evil stepmother, and she threw the shirts onto the boys and they turned into swans. However, she didn't know about the daughter, and the daughter for some reason had stayed behind in the castle, so she hadn't seen the daughter either. So yeah, thinking, she had gotten rid of the children, she just went back home. And yeah, of course the daughter hadn't actually seen her, so when her father came, she could only tell that her brothers had turned into swans and, randomly flew off. But she didn't know that it was her stepmother who did it, so the king didn't know either, so he didn't suspect her. However, the daughter was like, okay, now I'm here in this castle all alone, that isn't fun. So she decided to actually go look for her brothers. And eventually, when a normal person starts wandering in a forest, they just get lost, like her father did in the first place. But she eventually actually finds a cottage and meets her brothers there, who can apparently turn back into human beings for 15 minutes per night. And they actually tell her that there is one way to save them. She needs to not speak and not laugh for 6 whole years. And also make 6 shirts out of esters. One for each of them. And yeah, if she does all of that, then they might turn back into human beings if she throws shirts on top of them. I would completely fail at that, by the way. Like, not talking for 6 years. Like, I can't even shut up for 6 minutes. But yeah, anyway, she decides to try it because obviously she didn't have anything better to do anyway. And yeah, so that's how that goes. And then for some reason, one day she's sitting up in a tree making shirts out of esters. I don't know why she was sitting in a tree, that's just how the story tells it. And she gets found by a group of hunters. Who were actually hunters who were employed by a different king. Apparently, I hope, at least a younger king than her father. And they actually took her to the king. And despite her not laughing and not talking, the king fell in love with her. Yeah, I mean, if I don't laugh at someone and just stare at them grumpily and don't say a word to them, people don't usually like me, but for some reason the king fell in love with her anyway. And yeah, he married her and they had children. Let's just take a moment to really think about how awkward the sex must have been, but anyway, they got children and yeah. At that point, the stepmother had actually found out about the girl and proceeded to steal her children. So the girl would get, you know, actually suspected of killing her own child. And yeah, so that happened. And she actually, like, the girl actually, you know, got convicted for the crime. However, right at the perfect moment, her brothers arrived back. And yeah, the 6 years had passed and she hadn't spoken, she hadn't laughed, she'd done, you know, her job of sewing the shirts out of esters, threw them onto her brothers, and they turned back into people, and then the evil stepmother got punished, and the girl and the king and her brothers lived happily ever after, because it's a fairy tale, so yeah, that's an entire story. It's actually a story that I've always quite liked, mostly because I just think the pictures of the swans in the fairy tale book I have looked very pretty. But yeah, anyway, the scenes I decided to draw, well, it's pretty much I drew 2 of the swans, and also the girl holding up a shirt, presumably made out of esters. Realistically, it should have probably been green. However, the green probably wouldn't have stood out enough against the green backdrop. So I decided to make the shirt blue. And yeah, then here's the final result. I'm actually quite pleased with how it turned out. I really had some issues thinking of how to paint the girl. Because it had to be recognizable. But it couldn't be too small, obviously. Because it had to be on my nails. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. And I hope you enjoyed hearing me sort of tell the fairy tale in a hopefully amusing way. If you did like this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you'd like to, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.